I'm really sorry to say this, but I'm afraid your tests have come back positive. You have got oral cancer. As a dentist, these are some of the most gut-wrenching words that we can ever say to someone. And the hardest part? Telling them that their disease has progressed and it's too late for a full recovery. Every year, 500,000 people get diagnosed with oral cancer globally. Majority of them are the poor and the vulnerable living in South Asian countries, where it is the leading cause of cancer-related deaths in men. Research has shown that early detection while the disease is still in its precancerous stage is the key to better disease outcomes. It saves money and it saves lives. So what is stopping these people from getting the help they need to catch it before it's cancer? Firstly, the cost of attending dental services is beyond the reach of many people. Secondly, there simply aren't enough dentists. There are places in India where there is one dentist to look after 250,000 people. So is there anything we can do to help? Well, through my research, I aim to bring low-cost cancer screening services to these communities. Services that don't rely on dentists but can be delivered by any non-specialist healthcare worker. How am I going to do it, you ask? Well, I am working with head and neck cancer experts from all over the world to develop really simple step-by-step guidance on detecting oral precancers using just a mouth mirror, tweezers, and ordinary torchlight. This toolkit will be field tested with community health workers in rural parts of Uttar Pradesh in India. So who are these community health workers? They're a variety of health aides who are selected, trained, and work for the communities that they come from and bridge the gap between their community and the local health services. These community health workers will be trained to screen tobacco users, not in a dental clinic with all the fancy equipment, but in a local, easily accessible setting within their community. This 5-minute screening process tackles two big challenges. It brings low-cost cancer detection services to these communities for as little as £2 per person. And it allows for task shifting from a dentist to a lay health worker. If there is anything that we can learn from this ongoing pandemic, it is that timely testing can mean a difference between life and death, more so in the poor and the marginalized. With this research, basic life-saving care can finally become a possibility for these communities. Thank you.